Good morning, students. Welcome to the second class of biology on the topic excretion. This topic is under the chapter life processes. So on the first day, we have already talked a bit about the structure of kidney. So to continue further, let us begin once again and revise the structure of kidney, which is the main human excretory organ. So let's go to the first slide. In this slide, you can see the human excretory system has been demonstrated very well. So in the first diagram, you can see the kidney. They are a pair of reddish brown, solid, bean shaped structures lying in the abdominal cavity and attached to the dorsal body wall, one on either side of the vertebral column. Left kidney lies at a slightly higher level and near the midline than the right one. The size is around 10 centimeters in length, 5 to 6 centimeters in breadth, and about 4 centimeters in thickness. Each kidney has a convexity on the outer side, as you can see over here, and a concavity on the inner side. The concave side has a fissure or hilus for the entry of the renal artery. You can see here this blue colored tube, that is your renal artery. The renal artery, and for the exit of the renal vein and the ureter. This is the ureter. This is the ureter's tube. Renal artery brings oxygenated blood laden with waste products, and renal vein carries deoxygenated blood from which waste products have been removed. The structural and the functional or filtration unit of kidney is the nephron, or we can say the uriniferous tubules. About 1 million nephrons occur in each kidney. A nephron has got basically two parts: the Malpighian body or the renal corpuscle, that is consists of a blind cup shaped broader end of the nephron called the Bowman's capsule, and a bunch of fine blood vessels or capillaries called the glomerulus. Glomerulus develops from the afferent arteriole. As you can see over here, the afferent arteriole is entering into the glomerulus. It gives rise to the efferent arteriole. The diameter of the efferent arteriole is less than that of the afferent arteriole. As a result, blood comes under pressure in the glomerulus. It functions basically as a filtration unit. Bowman's capsule accommodates one glomerulus, and it is lined by flat cells, some of which have got small pores to allow the passage of materials filtered out of the glomerulus. Now the lower part, this one, is the renal tubule. This renal tubule has got three parts: the proximal convoluted tubule, or the PCT, the loop of Henle, which is U-shaped, and the distal convoluted tubule, or the DCT. The distal convoluted tubule opens into the collecting tubule. Collecting tubule forms pyramids and calyces, which opens into the pelvis. You can see this is the structure of the kidney, which is just cut open. Transverse section is cut open, and internally it looks like this. This area is the pelvis. So the pelvis, and this pelvis will lead into the ureter. So all parts of the renal tubule are covered by, this entire thing is covered by peritubular capillaries. It forms a network on the surface of this renal tubule, and it is actually formed from the efferent arteriole. The peritubular capillaries, they all join to form the renal venule. So what is the main work of this nephron? The main work of the nephron is to take part in the formation of urine. So it mainly works in the formation of urine. Now here in this diagram, you can see the excretory system in an enlarged form. Here you can see the renal vein, which carries the filtrated blood from the kidney to the heart. This is the urinary bladder, which stores urine. Then this is the urethra, which carries the urine from the bladder to the outside of the body. From the kidney is coming out this tube, what we call as a ureter. It carries urine from the kidney to the bladder. And here you can see this red colored pipe, the tube, which is the renal artery. This renal artery carries the blood from the heart to the kidney. So this is how the excretory system of a human being looks. So now here we just summarize the functions of the different parts of the kidney. Kidney and its parts, the excretory system and its parts actually. So what is kidney is doing? That is, it is actual place of filtration and reabsorption. What is the work of the ureter? Urine flows from the collecting tubes in the kidneys to the ureter. Ureter is actually a pipe. What is the work of urinary bladder? Urine flows from the ureter to the bladder, where it is stored temporarily, and time to time it is excreted. Then comes the urethra, the tube extending from the urinary bladder. There periodically urine is excreted from the bladder through the urethra. Now let us talk in detail about nephron. So what is nephron? Nephron is actually the structural and the functional unit of the kidney. So the millions of nephrons go to make up a kidney. The Bowman's capsule, as I have already shown you in the figure, it leads into a tubular structure which joins to form the collecting duct. The renal artery brings all kinds of nitrogenous wastes like your ammonia, urea, uric acid, excess of water, salts, etc. into the nephron. That is your glomerulus in the Bowman's capsule. There it filters the nitrogenous waste, water and salts. Then it passes through the tubular structure, that is that the proximal convoluted tubule, the loop of Henle and the distal convoluted tubule, finally leading into the collecting duct. The waste then passes through the ureters into the urinary bladder and is then sent out through the urethra as urine. Now when these waste products have come to the glomerulus, along with that there are many useful substances also which come along, like your amino acids, glucose, salts. So the body is very judicial about it, and it cannot afford to lose them. So what it does, it reabsorbs all these useful products by the capillaries around the tubular part, what we call, or what I have already stated, the peritubular capillaries. There everything is reabsorbed and then it goes into the renal vein. Now actually a healthy person excretes about 1 to 2 liters of urine per day. So basically, what is the role of the kidney? It basically performs two main functions. Firstly, filters out the nitrogenous waste from the blood, and secondly, it performs the function of osmoregulation. And in the very beginning of my discussion, I have already stated, what is osmoregulation? It is simply the maintenance of the right amount of water and ionic balance in the body. Now let us proceed to the next slide. Here you can see the enlarged diagram of your nephron. So here you can see the afferent arteriole that is entering into the glomerulus. This is the Bowman's capsule. This is the tube which is near the Bowman's capsule. That's why it is called as the proximal tubule. Then here is your loop of Henle. These are your peritubular capillaries. This is the distal convoluted tubule. Then finally that ends up into the collecting duct. And here you can see some branches being drawn over here. That is what we call as the tubes are entering from another nephron. So this is an enlarged structure on the diagram showing the structure of your nephron. Here the nephron structure is broken down. The Bowman's capsule at the top and the tubular part at the bottom. So the Bowman's capsule looks like this cup-like structure which collects the glomerulate filter. Now the glomerulus, what is it? It is the tightly packed structure which is actually the blood capillaries. And what is its work? Its work is only to filter the blood which enters under high pressure. Now this is the tubular part. This tubular part, in this part, reabsorption of useful substances takes place from the glomerular filtrate. And then finally it goes into the collecting duct. In the collecting duct also, reabsorption of water takes place and concentration of urine happens over here. Then it carries the urine from the nephron to the ureter. This duct is the one which carries the urine from the nephron to the ureter. Let's proceed to the next slide. In this slide, you can see what are the different kinds of ions or the molecules that are absorbed or secreted during the process of urine formation. That is when the filtrate passes through the tubular structure, passing from the glomerulus. So here it is demonstrated with the help of arrows. So the first step is actually glomerular filtration. So in this slide, actually the mechanism of urine formation has been demonstrated. So the blood flows in glomerulus under pressure due to the narrowness of the efferent arteriole. As a result, it undergoes pressure filtration, or what we can call as the ultrafiltration. All small volume of solutes, your urea, uric acid, amino acid, hormones, glucose, ions, vitamins and water are filtered out and they enter into the Bowman's capsule. The product is now known as nephric or the glomerular filtrate. Then what happens, you know, it proceeds down and reabsorption happens. So nephric filtrate is also known as primary urine. So it passes into the proximal convoluted tubule the peritubular capillaries, which have in the previous diagram I have shown you that it is all surrounded by a network of tubes, that is your peritubular capillaries around the proximal convoluted tubule, reabsorb all the useful components of this nephric filtrate, that is your glucose, amino acids, potassium ions, then your calcium ions, water, then chlorides, bicarbonates, all these things are absorbed. So selective reabsorption also occurs in the region of this distal convoluted tubule. The amount of water absorption depends upon the amount of excess water present in the body and the amount of dissolved waste that is supposed to be excreted. Then what happens? Tubular secretion also takes place. Tubular secretion is also known as augmentation process. It mostly occurs in this distal convoluted tubule. The secretion function happens only in the distal, mostly happens in the distal convoluted tubule, which is also surrounded by peritubular capillaries. Tubular secretion is active secretion of waste products by the blood capillaries into the urinary tubule. It ensures the removal of all the waste products from the blood, that is your urea, uric acid, creatinine, extra salts, that is potassium and hydrogen, are also secreted into the urinary tubule to maintain a proper concentration and pH of urine. So that is, in this part, extra salts of potassium and hydrogen are secreted into this urinary tubule, that is your PCT, the DCT, the distal convoluted tubule, to maintain a proper concentration and the pH of urine. Then in the last part of the urine formation is the concentration of urine. So 75% of the water content of the nephric filtrate is reabsorbed in this proximal convoluted tubule, and some 10% of the water passes out of the filtrate through osmosis in the area of the loop of Henle. It is because the loops of Henle are immersed in hyperosmotic interstitial fluid. Further concentration takes place in the area of this collecting tubules, that is in the presence of antidiuretic hormone or ADH, which is also known as vasopressin. This hormone is secreted only when concentrated urine is to be passed out, and it is not secreted when a person drinks lots of water. So absence of antidiuretic hormone produces a dilute urine. Hormone action therefore maintains osmotic concentration of body fluids, and deficiency of antidiuretic hormone causes excessive repeated dilute urination. So this is how urine formation takes place in the nephron. So this is a brief summary of what we have discussed under the four heading. Glomer, first step of urine formation is the glomerular filtration, which creates a plasma-like filtrate of the blood. The second step is tubular reabsorption, which removes the useful solutes from the filtrate and returns them to the blood. The third step is tubular secretion, which removes additional wastes from the blood and adds them to the filtrate. And the fourth step is urine concentration, whereby it removes the water from the urine and concentrates the wastes, and all the water is absorbed. Maximum amount of water is absorbed, as water is very precious for the body of human beings. So now all the urine that has been pumped now is These are the two tubes, that is your ureters, which conveys the urine from the kidneys to the bladder, passes from the pelvis to the posterior aspect of your urinary bladder. Then in the urinary bladder, this is your internal structure of the urinary bladder. This sac lies posterior to the pubical area and separated from the rectum by the seminal vesicles in male and by the vagina and uterus in the female. It serves as a temporary reservoir for urine and it gradually fills up and then it becomes distended. Then time to time through the urethra, the urine passes out and it is led to the external urethral orifice from where it is excreted out. So this is what we have to learn in the process of urine formation. And this was your discussion on the topic human excretory system. That's all for now. Thank you.